What?
Wait.
So obviously, you know what happened last time. We got lost for 6 hours underground. Total of 8 hours underground. This time we're going back, we're more equipped. We know where we're going, we have maps. We have some more explorers who know the place like the back of their hand.
People have been contacting me, telling me that there's plans afoot for various things in the UK, kicking off with this Area 51, running in and asking questions about the UFOs. And if it's gonna happen in the UK, I would have imagined that this Caution would have been one of the places where people kick off. So I don't think they're telling people where it's going to happen just yet, but when it comes down, if it's over there, and I think it probably will be, then I'll be heading over there. So
I will too.
There you go.
We'll be in the front line. And then after that, yeah, like, even though if I get lost now, I always end up coming onto a corridor that I know. So it just does that one. But
so why do you believe that it's so secure? Why are they trying so hard to keep people out of there?
Well, it's hard to see, but they're doing something. Yeah. They are definitely up to something. They've just shut Skynet Drive off again. They're getting really hot on it again, whereas before, we've been going down there recently, loads, setting the alarm off loads, getting no interest from the police.
Okay.
But of recent, we've started going down there, and the minute they're seeing cameras now at the Red Door and that, they're actually responding to it and sending police out, and they're sitting around wasting their own police hours, waiting at gates for people just to come out of possibly what they think's the entrance.
Well, if they're rushing police out, obviously they're worried about somebody else being down there, aren't they?
Yeah. Yeah, but that's what the thing is. It's obviously the time I've been going down there, it got shut in 2004, like classified, and that's when they announced it and all that.
Yeah.
And then, like, the camera got taken down, there's fans stopped in there, and then by 2013 they took all the asbestos walls down. And then it was like last year they put the camera back up with alarms and everything else, and then the fans come back on. So it was like, it was getting more and more.
It's all been reactivated down there. You can hear it the minute you get anywhere near it. You can hear all the noise coming from the other side of that door.
What's it sound like?
Oh, it's just a big fan, but for the fans to be on, that's costing a hell of a lot of money to run them fans. So there's obviously a reason they're running the fan.
But that's in the door that you can even, when you knock on it, that one actually echoes where, like, the other one I'll show you as well.
It just sounds like
that
tin.
One, literally, you just, and that's it, it's so pure solid. That one's got no camera or nothing, that one.
No, it's like knocking on the floor.
Yeah.
So what do you think will happen if we were to, say, go knocking on this door trying to get their attention today?
We're going to find out.
We're going to find out.
We are going to find out.
If we do get their attention, though...
We are going to get their attention, that's 100%.
All right, are we going to bum rush them with questions?
We're going to rush them with questions or rush away from them. It depends how you feel at the time. If you want to go and speak to them, you go and speak to them. I know, personally, I'm not going to be talking to them.
Oh, okay.
Depends what they're coming with, doesn't it?
Yeah, yeah.
They usually just wait at the entrance. Not actually at the entrance, but like possible entrances. And then they've only got an hour's timeline for you, so you've got to like be at the door for a little bit, then go out. You've got an hour, and then after that they can't wait for you. They've got to go.
So
they've got an hour.
So you say.
Yeah, that's what they said to us last time anyway. But these two got away.
And they're not actually allowed to come into the caves because
they're not insured. Mm. None of them insured. Fire Brigade and all that are not insured because obviously that's why. Like if you ring them up, you have to ring up 999, then Cave Rescue. And then obviously they get all the like Wessex clubs and all the other places, like cable places, and then they go down there.
Nice.
Yeah. So.
Well, this was old World War II air raid shelter in Liverpool, which basically, as far as we know, has been sealed up for God knows how long. If you notice, even all of the paint and everything, it's not spray paint, it's literally just paint cans. It's like.
Yeah, brush film.
But inside it's got. Inside it's got the.
We just have to go in now with Dania, and it's pretty dark. I'm gonna keep it secret. So we'll see you on the inside. Right, we're just about to go in to box. Ooh. Yeah, there's some nice people who've pulled the grills away, so we're gonna get in and in. Make use of that before the MOD come and close up the grill again. Because there's one thing you'll be sure of, the MOD don't leave those grills open for long.
Dear, dear.
We're just waiting for that rod.
Cheers, man.
Grab
this
shit. What is it? Just stash it somewhere down
there. Down there.
Right.
Fucking rock here. Secret bolt.
Basically the end last, you'll know anyway, because that's the entrance there, isn't it? Right, and there you go.
Under Bessus, is it?
Yeah.
Down the street. Get the strangest fucking looks of everyone we meet.
Sorry,
I
was just checking the camera.
Well,
you've
shot
a sweet sorted.
Yeah, it's on low. Nice and sharp. Yeah.
You need to have a weight feature in it.
Daisy, what's your lip is?
Slippy,
powdery slippy.
It looks kind of steampunk, like Industrial Revolution.
Yep. Yeah, I've seen a few over the years. We go along now. Just get my glasses on. So, if you keep moving, it doesn't steam up. La Secret Welt.
But they also keep the air ducts on to keep all the paperwork and stuff, like they've stored in.
Alright, yeah, a bit drier. Yeah, I get you. So the chances are, it's not vacant.
Tunnel quarry, like I said, still active. Burlington, like spring quarry and that, they say it's not, but like.
And before we go any further, what is your opinion on the base? Do you think there's sinister things going on? Do you think it is the UK's Aerial 51? What is your opinion on it?
I know it's just a bunker bit in there, like that's all I know on it. Like, I don't know on the Area 51 bit.
But what is your opinion?
Above the ground bit on the Rodney Manor bit was all the Area 51 type of stuff.
Yeah.
But unless they moved it in there. But then, yeah.
Yeah, because I heard rumours that the documents from Rodlow Manor all got stored into Burlington.
Yeah. You get a load of things stored in there. You've got so many sections, different areas of sections where they store stuff. But then it goes down to, like, they got butter packs, like, in there.
Oh yeah, that was for in case of a nuclear attack.
Yeah,
or
they got all
of
that.
It got kind of decommissioned of it as a nuclear bunker because the water leaks would have been radiation leaks.
To a degree, and obviously they asked for a £20 million upgrade in the like the 90s and that, and obviously like you said they got refused it.
Yeah.
So, but they did sell the land above, and they stated that it come with the bunker, but they can do nothing with it except for storage with it. And then they said in the small print, if need be, we'll take back and put back into action.
Yeah,
which is probably have. Then, like I said, all the other stuff has been sold as well, and then they're taking all that back, and then the camera went back up.
It's just funny how Skynet Drive in that post, actually, now I remember it. That was September, isn't it? They're shutting the gates off and putting all the signs up.
They've got to be doing something.
Do you reckon that's got anything to do with what they're planning in America at Area 51, that they think the same thing might happen here?
I've heard rumours that the UK Area 51 storm is coming.
Glory hole, isn't it? Well, for women. Get your bits on that, like fucking get it up there.
Oh yeah.
Sounds interesting. You know what I've got, mate? Fucking C Max diesel. Yeah. The new shape one.
So
it's just a family thing, though.
Yeah, but diesel all the way, man.
Yeah. It's only a 1.6 engine.
Yeah, it doesn't matter, man.
Like,
that diesel
there
was only a 1.9, mate.
I used to like my Vecchies, mate.
What's your age?
Oh, it's
Vauxhall Vectras. Oh, yeah,
mate. The 1.9 one was lethal.
Yeah.
I've had a V6, but I think it was shit.
Like. I had the V6 one, 2.5 V6.
Yeah, with two-figure exhaust at the back.
Yeah. I had
Calibra. Yeah. Oh, mate, them engines are lethal, yeah. Especially if you're dropping in a f***ing over.
Yeah, 2-litre red top.
Yeah. Powerful engine.
16 brakes for 2 motors.
Get up some speed now.
Yeah. The Fiat Tower is a nice car. You get a lot of problems with the engine that we didn't
have. 64,000 miles in the year, you've got to be good.
Hey Dan, is there one of the Victorian like pictures of the horses in that here? There's a few of them horses.
Where's the horses?
Down here.
Oh wow. Oh yeah. Old Victorian.
Just a laptop actually.
Well, I think it's Victorian. Yeah, it must be both Victorian drawings from the mines. We saw some last time. It's all the old trains and the like coal.
Right, so I sat by that electric box here with the 4G antenna in.
Yeah.
On the left hand side.
Yeah.
Can you not look at the picture properly? It actually looks like a grey alien.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Side of that box, I was sat up on a little slip, just
they're not the best of artists, are they?
Could
be wonky to them.
Yeah, basically, I heard someone walking up the island just after the walk around. And then going,
bear with us a minute, bear with us a minute.
Obviously, straight away after that, bear with us.
It's a bit wet later on. This is because we're in a part that we never came in. I've never been down this far south. You've got to keep moving, otherwise your camera bloody steams up, isn't it?
So everyone, what I'm doing right now, I have a GoPro on. I'm recording every movie.
You actually look like a bunch of miners from the distance.
I'm recording every movie, which will go on the vlog channel. Completely uncut, probably about
to have a little bit.
Walk through it all this mine. So if you want to see that, head over to my vlog channel, Dan Vlogs, all the link in the description below. Actually, you can click this icon right now. If you want to subscribe to the channel, it'll be posted.
It's so sketchy.
That video will be posted an hour after this episode drops, so you can watch this episode and you can go over to the vlog channel and watch the full walkthrough of this place.
Completely uncut. That's an interesting support beam.
Oh, is this where we're going?
This is what's supporting out the window right now.
You're thinking just really go that way and walk around it.
Be aware, when you're filming yourself, you've got your light on, and for me looking at you, you're just like, pfft.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So watch yourself.
Is it really? Yeah, no, I guess not. I have to go this way. Mind your head.
The aliens.
Yeah, put him in my backpack.
If
ET's
not there, will we be coming back this way? Why do you want to leave your backpack?
No, I don't think we are coming back this way.
Trouble is, there could be somebody else
in
here. It's unlikely, but you never know.
I mean, you can stash it in between.
Right, we're going to have to keep moving anyway, because he needs to stop and have some medication for his ankle. Hang on, bro.
What's going on?
No, it's just because he's had an operation on his legs, he stopped taking some pain relief.
Oh, that's it.
Gimbal's battery going now.
Find your head up here.
There are going to be cameras where you can bring it.
recording, change batteries in the gimbal.
Thank you.
That has been the report with the other team, and it was lost for 8 hours, and they could not find a way out of here. But I'm not surprised, because the quake is absolutely massive. I'm not going to lie. There's just different passageways everywhere. And all they had last time was a compass. So,
yeah. We did have a map. We did have a map.
Oh, a map, sorry.
But the compass was getting affected by the gimbal. I didn't realise it, but the magnetic field was coming out about this far.
So looking for that compass, they made it all alive.
In the corner of his mouth while he was thinking around his back.
Bit slippy this one, watch it. Yeah, man. Oh, it's an adrenaline rush. You haven't got time to think, you just gotta get your feet down. Yeah. Now, be prepared for something quite cool. Whoa. Watch this down to the right, that goes down a long way, don't go down there. Avoid that.
How deep is it?
Oh, it's not the deepest, last time.
Yeah.
It's not the deepest in the world.
Yeah. You'd have a job getting out of it.
I'm not going to look down it, because it will go down.
There's holes on the sides.
Yeah, if you go to the room, you can load up a minute.
Yeah, I'm going to have a minute. Oops, the baby.
Remember, guys, it's muddy.
Is Carl going to be gutted because he didn't manage to come down? We'll have to get him in on a separate one.
Who?
Carl Hassel.
Oh, is he? What? Did he want to come
down? Well, he said before, didn't he? He was like, oh yeah, I'll come down and do it again. And Steve Ronin.
And Steve missed out, I've already said that.
Yeah, we might maybe get him in on another trip, like, you know, a month or so's time. These lads will do it fucking every day of the week.
That rock is loose, don't put any weight on it, he just fell down.
Right.
Cool.
Knees.
Yeah, well, there's some dodgy climbs, isn't there? Sinking it. What the hell was that?
It's an old crane.
Holding the ceiling.
In the ceiling. Feel aching after getting out here. Tell you what, I'm not sweating so much now I got my bloody hoodie on. For some reason, I'm not sweating now.
That's tacky, isn't it?
Mm.
Tight squeeze. That was a tight squeeze. Right there, Matt.
Bosh. Yeah, feeling a lot better now.
Yeah,
it's having this sweat, you know, top on, like, you know, just stop me sweating now. Uh-oh.
Something's wrong.
Battery. Just knock the battery off. Thank you.
this one here, Matt, please.
Yeah, if you step on it,
yeah. Downhill, slalom, very nice when you've got somebody who knows where they're going and you don't have to think about it. Onward.
Yeah, that's right.
flooring is fake.
Okay.
I'll show you the where he was going to run the piping for it.
Is this a 28 gay later room?
No, that's just up there.
I didn't bother bringing that yellow material because we'd have to have laid it out all the way.
You can see how old some of these are. Now, I've heard stories that this is either made with chalk or the flame of the lanterns. They actually hold the flame up against the wall to do the drawing sometimes. And you can see how old this is because it's got a flat cap on. And he's smoking like a pipe, so it's definitely, you know, Victorian.
Sorry, man.
Definitely Victorian era. But yeah, that's what they used to do, used to hold the lanterns up with the flame on the wall, and that's how they were able to draw sometimes. That's cool. Bit of history there.
So that's where the stereotypical Brit comes from, like a Sherlock Holmes type guy.
Yeah, the Sherlock Holmes type person, yeah. Well, that was Victorian, you know.
I know. Did you know Americans?
Industrial Revolution, everyone wanted to look like that. That was the Industrial Revolution catalogue, catalogue.
Most Americans still think Brits look like that.
I know. Most Americans think that we wake up in the morning and I'm like, oh, where's my tea and crumpets?
Yeah, it's actually, my dad is exactly like that.
Okay.
Before school.
Yeah, dad isn't helping.
Tea at school.
He has a portable tea set in the back of his car. That's how British he is.
Okay, maybe down south. Oh, in the north, you don't do that.
No, in the north.
In the north.
Isn't that above it?
North of the wall.
In the north, it's all about pasties.
That is some artwork right there, isn't it, mate?
Okay, so...
Well, now that...
I think that was actually done with chalk.
Wait, film me for a second with your camera. You just mentioned the 28 Days Later thing, right?
Yeah.
Now, you guys, you can see the prophecy has come to life. They foresaw in the past, in the Victorian times, that someone was going to come in here and do this very thing in this mine. And we found the ancient prophecy that came true.
Well said, Andrew. Well said. So what's that one?
That's them bum fucking each other.
Okay, I'll cut that.
No, keep it.
Another one. Another one. 28 plops later.
28 plops later.
Plops. Ploppy poos.
But there's another one. That's a small pie.
Just take a penis
on his back, but I
just meant
to be
Just say bomb.
What are we looking at? Wow. Hello. 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 Oh. Sorry, what
is this? This is a well.
It's a well.
One there.
Whoa.
It's a big hole.
You can't... Holy crap. That is a big hole.
And there. The prophecy also said that they would be dumped in a hole. So
the prophecy said after they boomed each other, this is as big as their gaping assholes were. You can cut that out if you want.
At least they surveyed it, so that means
28 prolapsed anuses later.
Oh, I have a question. Is that from the Bitcoin times in the cursive where it says cunt?
Maybe.
I think that's a message 28 days later.
Oh, but that's the case.
No, there it is. This is some fucking artwork, man.
Wow, look at that. I never saw that. It's actually... Is that carved in?
Yep. There's one bit of choice here as well. It's from this angle you can see it's like chip.
Yeah, there's a face
chip. That's what 98% of 28 Days Later users look like after they get their subscription
and
locked off for just asking a simple question.
That's a bit of hostility there, Matthew.
Yeah, I think I lasted about 2 days on there.
That's ominous. The funny thing is, I find it hilarious how they bully all people who go onto the website.
Yeah.
They go on and all you read is bullying non-stop.
You basically can't you can't get it right. You know, you say A, they say no, it's B. You say B, it's no, it's A. And you can actually log on as a different user and try the other way around. You will never win.
It's crazy. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, not nice people.
You can go onto many of the Facebook forums and you can see the 28 Days Later people like bullying other people who want to get into exploring. And yeah, I just don't get it. I really don't get it.
They just make it an elite club where you're not supposed to know. And if you ask, you broke the cardinal rule, so get right. Be gone.
So you know what? I want to go and just get out there and explore.
Yeah, I mean, you know, so what if people know the locations? Why does 28 Days Later get to tell people what the rules are? And can I see the rule book? Oh no, you can't see the rule book. Oh, but I broke the rule book. Yeah. Right.
Oh wow, no, look at that behind. Like a demon woman.
A rat lippy.
What's a rat lippy?
I don't know, but that might be some kind of.
Is that Minnie Mouse or Mickey Mouse at his time?
Well, that's what I was thinking, yeah. That's a bit creepy.
If anybody in chat knows what this could possibly signify, it says the rat lippy. Here's a demon and some very disturbing Mickey Mouse sort of imagery to it. And this is obviously really old.
That looks like Hitler.
It does look like him.
Look,
yeah.
It's had a swastika, but somebody crossed it out.
Yeah, you're right.
Oh, yeah.
Well, now that is some history there. That is the bad man from Germany himself.
I wonder if that was like an insult back in the day, the rat lippy.
There is a rich quarry.
Oh, there's a rat woman. Can see the rat?
Bitten image of
Hitler. Yeah. Maybe he's not to do with the rat lippy.
Maybe it has something to do with his mustache?
Yeah. No, but I don't know. I think the rat was actually afterwards or before. I don't know. But
no idea.
My camera's picking up this facial recognition.
They're a good artist, obviously. Whoever did it, very talented.
This is the original dart used to be. It used to say dart places there.
That's where they changed it to 28 days, right there.
It was right smack back here.
Well, it's spelled out with a brush.
Yeah, do it here.
It's okay if you want to get a photo 20 years later, just...
Yeah?
Right, well, I'm not going to sit here and do it by myself. You'll have to help if you want the photo. Where are we starting?
have been 28 days your length.
Instant classic.
Yeah. Should I give you a free pass for the day?
Yes.
To be anti-gay?
Okay, so obviously people are going to say, oh, that's really anti-gay, it's not at all. And you know, I could be the furthest from being homophobic. In fact, I'm stood next to my very dear gay friend Matthew right now. So,
who also took photos with
him. Also took photos with him, yeah. So, yeah, none of that.
But that and your
fight. I'm not leaving his side.
Yeah, well, to be honest, I get a lot of love messages off Matthew on Facebook. And then when he's using, funny enough, first I was like, what the hell's going on? When he sends me messages, he calls me Dad. And it only later on I realised.
Look at those among the line. I'm working for Spirit King.
How much do
they love me?
A lot.
They're obsessed.
Oh, yeah, just a little bit.
Really obsessed.
Hmm.
There's his name behind it.
I mean, you're watching this right now, you know who you are, and you know what I did. And I know you took
a picture online.
And I know you took
down
a fit.
And you're going to have to see it
where that came from. I know a lot of you. I know.
Did you say the gay film?
Reads the back. 20 days later.
It's unfortunate if someone has the face with.
I've got the profiles.
Something else so nice.
I think you filmed the film before.
Cables.
It's better now, isn't it, after a bit.
Remember what you said about them spike pad things at the entrance?
Getting a little perk where?
The secret vault. Like, subscribe. And don't donate to me on Patreon, because no one ever does that. They did try to stop people going in here for a while. Dan, I think you're going to see the red door.
No, I don't think we are, mate. Holy crap, tell me now, what is this,
Oh, what? Plate?
Solid. That's why I've gone from the other side.
Bugger.
They've sealed one of the doors.
Yeah. Mmm. They're taking it seriously, aren't they?
Yeah. And I was trying to go the other way, then. There's more ways?
Yeah.
Well, maybe I spoke too soon. Dan, maybe you're going to see the red door.
As you can maybe. See, we have gone out of the way to see all this part of the door.
There's a really thick door. That's the entrance part of the doorway. And then literally to the left is where we'll be going up. And then that takes us to the other deep with the camera door.
Right, okay.
So we can see the red door, do you think?
But apparently they have
Scary. Fan on the wall, air vent fan. Oh, what? Is that proper metal doors? No. No way. Oh my God. Oh, this is bullshit.
Mental, I've blocked it off, isn't it?
Oh my God. Hang on, so you're telling me there's nothing going on in this underground base anymore? They seem to be having a bit of a meltdown over us coming here.
Into the ground. Well gone through there.
Watch out.
see it's all bolted onto the wall there. That
yeah, that's Matty, that goes the whole length of that. That's going to be welded all the way along there.
Mm. Oh my god, and it says FRPWF across it.
Yeah.
Oh shit. Anyone notice that? Well, that's annoying. They really do love you, dude.
Well, apologise about that, people. But that is, end of this corridor is the door.
It says there, look. Red door, alarm, 20 metres.
We're done. We'll get you in.
That's not
even to drop you down a bloody air shaft, we'll get you in.
Wonder how deep that is. Wonder how deep that is.
Off both sides.
What about that seaport going into this place? They have got it on lockdown. Behind this is a camera and a secret red door. And the point of that is when people who couldn't get into the room.
That's some heavy duty shit right there.
You even blocked off this bit.
That's actually just resting against it. You could probably push that over.
Oh yeah, you could.
See when you cut the circle out.
Damn it. That's not cool. It's that Hamlet cigar moment now. Cool. Radon affected area. This is what the Exploring with Fighters guys want to do. They won't see our faces if we're shining the lights straight at them. They'll blind their lights. You can hear the fan is on. It's quite an uphill climb this. It levels out, yeah. See, they're not doing anything underground, honestly. It's all shut down. Nothing to see here, folks. This is not the new GCHQ at all. Nothing to see here. Not looking down at us. Might be off. I'm not seeing any sort of like glow from it.
No, I picked up my phone in the infrared.
You've got it on your phone, have you?
Just about me out
of
there.
Oh yeah. You can see it on yours.
When I was a lot further back, I picked up a lot more.
Well, it's not looking at us anyway. I knew the fans going. So that's definitely still being used underground, all being reactivated. If you don't believe it, listen to your own ears. But look. Yeah. Cool, man.
still recording. It's amazing.
Yeah.
Obviously, it wants to film the exciting underground stuff. Great. Quite high chambers by here. My camera, which wouldn't record all this evening, is now recording. Amazing. Yeah, it's recording all right now. Yeah. Somebody should spray on the lens, really, of that fucking thing. Just get a spray can. Yeah. Well, obviously, whoever wrote that came here after Exploring the Fighters.
Yeah.
I'll tell Exploring My Fighters to bring a spray can then and update that one.
Well, I haven't kind of like reacted too much because I was quite tired, so I had a little power nap. Oh, but the lads were
a bit gutted.
Just something on the floor. Bit gutted because there's big metal grills up there and you can't get in, and they tried to see around it and they couldn't see, so we'll come back down here again. The chances are that somebody's gonna get really peed off with that, and they will attempt to get in, not us, somebody will, and if we come down here at the right time, we'll benefit from their hard work, but we can go in. We shall see. But, yeah. Oh. Military. Is it like to spoil people's fun? You know, even if they're most likely just going to look at the red door, walk away. So, what's the big deal? I seem to be a bit paranoid about something. Maybe people try to get in there for this storm area 51. Maybe they think that they're going to try that here, so preparing themselves for it. Ooh, well, we've got to walk back now, and then I'm probably going to fall asleep. So, oopsie daisy, what the hell is that? If I don't kill myself first, I'd light that way, so I don't break my neck. See you in a bit.